Semantic layer. Let's discuss the semantic layer. The semantic layer is a concept developed by a company called Business Objects, who obtained a patent in 1996. So what is it? A semantic layer is a business representation of corporate data that helps end users access data autonomously using common, non-technical business terms. In other words, software that ensures that the complex technical language of the database matches the current familiar business terminology. Let's see what it looks like in practice. In this example, you see the structure of the database with all fields and their names. This is often not very readable terminology, but technically essential. On the right side of the screen, you can see an example of what an end user sees. What has happened here is that a translation has been made that makes the name as shown to the end user inconsistent with how it actually appears in the database. When talking with someone in the database or BI department, they may have a different name than the one you're used to. So it's a good idea to establish whether you are in fact talking about the semantic name or the technical database name. What you should also take into account is that a semantic layer can also contain calculated fields, apart from the fields in the database. These are therefore fields that do not exist in the database, but are calculated by the data warehouse software. Think of sales, profit, ratios, and so on. In that case, it's very important that there's a good understanding within the company in terms of naming, so that if you need to talk about, for example, sales, everyone is on the same page. In conclusion, we have come to the end of this tutorial. You have learned how a star schema works and how you can use it to make reports. I hope that this tutorial has given you a good insight into the usefulness and necessity of the star schema, and hopefully you will be able to use it in your work. Thank you for your time, and good luck.